what is good, and what does the Lord require of you but to do justice and to love kindness and to walk humbly with your God? The choir will now sing Psalm 91.
The first lesson is from the 28th chapter of the book of Genesis, beginning with the 10th verse. Jacob left Beersheba and went toward Haran. He came to a certain place and stayed there for the night because the sun had set. Taking one of the stones of the place, he put it under his head and lay down in that place. And he dreamed that there was a stairway set up on the earth, the top of it reaching to heaven. And the angels of God were ascending and descending on it. And the Lord stood beside him and said, I am the Lord, the God of Abraham, your father, and the God of Isaac. The land on which you lie, I will give to you and to your offspring. And your offspring shall be like the dust of the earth. And you shall spread abroad to the west and to the east and to the north and to the south. And all the families of the earth shall be blessed in you and in your offspring. Know that I am with you and will keep you wherever you go and will bring you back to this land. For I will not leave you until I have done what I have promised you. Then Jacob woke from his sleep and said, Surely the Lord is in this place, and I did not know it. And he was afraid and said, How awesome is this place! This is none other than the house of God, and this is the gate of heaven. Here endeth the lesson.
The second lesson is taken from the first chapter of the Gospel according to John, beginning at the 43rd verse. The next day, Jesus decided to go to Galilee. He found Philip and said to him, "Follow me." Now Philip was from Bethsaida, the city of Andrew and Peter. Philip found Nathanael and said to him, "We have found him about whom Moses in the law and also the prophets wrote, Jesus, son of Joseph from Nazareth." Nathanael said to him, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" Philip said to him, "Come and see." When Jesus saw Nathanael coming toward him, he said to him, "Here truly is an Israelite in whom there is no deceit." Nathanael asked him, "Where did you get to know me?" Jesus answered, "I saw you under the fig tree before Philip called you." Nathanael replied, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Jesus answered, "Do you believe because I told you that I saw you under a fig tree? You will see greater things than these." And he said to him, "Very truly, I tell you, you will see heaven opened and the angel of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man." Here endeth the lesson.
Thank you. our darkness, we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of thy only Son, our Savior Jesus Christ.
This evening's anthem is an evening collect by this year's residency clinician, Simon Lowell. In the words of the composer, this text has to be one of the most beautiful evening prayers with its evocative language and has always resonated with me.
Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church and the world.
We pray for victims of war and those who have been displaced from their homes. We thank you, God, for providing places of refuge for those affected by war and for the love and safety afforded to us here today. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for our earth to be loved and preserved, and that we might use our power to nurture it as it has nurtured us. We thank you, God, for your servants who act towards the protection of our shared resources, and for all those who participate in stewarding your creation.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for the community in the church and all its members, that we may glorify God and spread his love. We thank you, God, for the fellowship found through the church. Fill us that we may continually find ways to serve and bless others. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for victims of gun violence, oppression, abuse, disenfranchisement, and those who are burdened with hidden afflictions. We thank you, God, for our leaders who guide us and give us counsel. Give them strength to persevere, the gift of grace, and the desire to follow your ways. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Keep, O Lord, your household, the church, in your steadfast faith and love, that through your grace we may proclaim your truth with boldness and minister your justice with compassion. For the sake of our Savior, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen.
Blessing and honor and thanksgiving and praise, more than we can utter, more than we can conceive, be to you, most holy and gracious Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, by all angels, all people, all creatures, forever and ever. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.